Jai Mishi and good morning everyone. Once again I came to life and I'm really happy to come in life this morning. Ra ma dherai khushi chu aaja ko biyani tapai ko maaj ma feri life ma aunu pauda. And I'm really happy and excited. This morning when I wake up and I was praying in the Holy Ghost and I was praying, again I let in my spirit to just share something to all of you. So I just came here. And I will speak the same thing which I was speaking yesterday about the hand of God. Ma tapai lai aaja pani tei kura bhannu gai rakheko chu jo maile hiju tapai lai bhaneko thie parmeshwar ko hat ko barema. It's really blessing for us to know the hand of God is upon us. Yo chai sachai nai euta aashish ko karan ho tapai ra मेरो निम्ति यो कुरा थाहा गर्नुको लागि कि परमेश्वरको हात हाम्रो माथि छ. सो एभ्री वान अफ अस ह्याभ टु अन्डरस्ट्यान्ड द ह्यान्ड विच इज अपन अस इज द ह्यान्ड अफ आवर क्रिएटर. इन दिस पेन्डेमिक टाइम मेनी पिपल आर अफ्रेड एन्ड आइ एम टेलिङ यु डोन्ट ह्याभ टु अफ्रेड बिकज द ह्यान्ड विच इज अपन अस इज द माइटी ह्यान्ड एन्ड द्याट्स पावरफुल. आई विल स्टार्ट with the same the words yesterday I was talking, the book of Isaiah chapter 41 verse 10. It says like this: fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you, I will help you, I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. So just think about that. The Bible clearly says fear not, for I am with you. The God who is the creator of this world himself is telling you and me that fear not, I am with you. And also he said, don't look here and there because I am your God and I will strengthen you. Ma tapai lai tagat dinchu, I will strengthen you, I will give you the strength. And he says, I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. That's powerful. In these days, that word really, really encouraged me. That word really bless my life, because the hand of God, when the hand of God is upon us, nobody can do anything. And you and I, we have to understand that truth. We have to get that revelation, the hand of God, because the hand. Yesterday also I was saying that many people says like this, mero agadi pani koi chaina pichadi pani chaina, nobody is there in the front, nobody is there in the back. But why should you look? किन तपाईँले अगाडि र पछाडिको कुरा हेरिराख्नुहुन्छ? बाइबल सेज द ह्यान्ड अफ गड इज अपन अस. सो जस्ट थिङ्क अबाउट द्याट, बिकज द ह्यान्ड अफ गड विच इज अपन यु इज नट द सिम्पल ह्यान्ड, द्याट्स द ह्यान्ड अफ गड, द ह्यान्ड विच इज द एबल टु प्रोटेक्ट युर लाइफ, द विच इज एबल टु ब्लेस यु, द्याट्स ह्यान्ड इज अबभ अस. सो वी डोन्ट ह्याभ टु एफ्रेड. सो दिस मर्निङ आई जस्ट फिल टु इन्करेज अल अफ यु एज यु आर गोइङ टु स्टार्ट युर डे. जसरी तपाईँले आफ्नो दिनलाई सुरु गर्नु जानुहुँदैछ, यस मेनी अफ यु माइट बी द अदर पार्ट अफ दिस वर्ल्ड, यु आर गोइङ टु स्लिप, बट बिफोर यु स्लिप आइ एम जस्ट गोइङ टु इन्करेज यु. सो द वर्ड अफ गड इज अलवेज पावरफुल. यु नो टुडे जस्ट रिड द बाइबल, द बुक अफ एक्सोडस च्याप्टर 15 वर्स 6 सेज लाइक दिस: युर राइट ह्यान्ड ओ लोर्ड ग्लोरियस इन पावर, युर राइट ह्यान्ड ओ लोर्ड send the enemy. The Bible says shatrula nas garcha. He says your hand, that's the right hand. He says, oh Lord, glorious in power. Parmeshwar ko hat yo chai shaktishali ho. He says glorious in power. The hand of God is the glorious in power. And he says your right hand, oh Lord, he says, the settle the enemies. So God's right hand is there for you and for me to just to destroy, or you can say the shaitan ko harek kaam harlai nash garcha. So the hand of God is for you and for me. We don't have to afraid. That's the Bible clearly says. So you and I, no matter what kind of situation you're going through, tapai kunai pani paristhiti bata kina najaos, तपाईँलाई यो कुरा थाहा गर्नुपर्छ कि परमेश्वरको हात तपाईँमाथि छ. यु हेभ टु नो द ह्यान्ड अफ गड इज अपन यु. द ह्यान्ड विच इज अपन अस इज द पावरफुल ह्यान्ड. द ह्यान्ड विच इज अपन अस is the mighty hand, who is the creator of this world, who is the savior of our life, who is the healer of our body. So you don't have to afraid, because the hand of God is always, always with us. The Bible says he will never leave us, not forsake us. The Isaiah, always the book of Isaiah 41 verse 10 is the clearly says, fear not, I am with you. So why should you afraid? In this pandemic time, nothing, if you have nothing, still you don't have to afraid, because the Bible says, fear not, I am with you. So you and I, we don't have to afraid. Just trust God. Just believe that the hand of God is upon you, and that hand is able to protect our life. That hand is able to provide all our needs. That hand is above, like the able to take us in the same place where we were. Many people might lost many things in this pandemic time. When I talk with the young people these days, many people say, Pastor, we lost our job. No job, no money, no food. Many people came back from their, like the workplace to their village, their town. Why? Because they don't have job. And now they are like kind of like the many people are discouraged. Many people are discouraged. Many people are disappointed. Many people are going in the depression. Why should we go? We should believe that the hand of God is upon us, and he will be able to take care of us. You don't have to be afraid. Tapailai darauko darkar chaina. You don't have to be afraid. If you also lost your job, if you also came back to your hometown or your village, and you're just worrying for your future, you're worrying for what you're going to do, how you're going to survive, how you're going to eat. So I just want to tell you that the hand of God is upon you. You know, the few days ago when I was reading the book of Matthew chapter 14, and here the Bible says that he is talking about the Jesus and disciples. It's talking about the story, the Jesus and the disciple. And Jesus said to the disciple, you go to the boat. And they were going, and Jesus separated himself, and he went some places sitting in the presence of God, and he was praying. And the Bible says, when the boat was in the middle, the Bible says Jesus, what he did, he was walking on the water, and he came towards the boat, towards the disciple. And the Bible says the disciples were afraid, and they thought it is ghost. And what happened? They shouted, they were feared, they cry out. And Jesus says, don't afraid, it's me. Don't afraid, it's me. Then Peter says one thing, Lord, if that's you, tell me to walk on the water and come towards you. So think about that scriptures. And the Bible says Jesus told him to come. And when he was coming, the Bible says he was looking to Jesus, and he was walking on the water. And suddenly when he saw the wind, the Bible says, what the Bible clearly says, he start to sink. Dubnu lagyo. And he cry out. And he says, Lord, help me. In that situation, he cry out and he says, Lord, help me. And what happened? The chapter 14, verse 31 says, immediately Jesus throws out his hand and catch him. See, his hand. He says he stretch out his hand and he catch him. When he stretch out his hand, even the water cannot draw him down. Jab Parmeshwar le apno hat la badaunu bhayo, tyo pani le pani Petrus lai dubaunu sakena. When Jesus stretched his hand, even water could not skin him. So the hand of God is powerful. So you and I, in the midst, if you thinking you're losing your job, you're losing your strength, you're losing your hope, you're losing your future, then cry out. Call the name of Jesus. Call the name of God. And you will see God is ready to stretch his hand. His hand is powerful. His hand, I'm telling you, his hand is powerful. And that hand is above you. That hand, the Bible says, the hand of God is on me. The hand of God is above me. So God's hand is able to save your life. The God's hand has the power to save your life, protect your life, provide your needs, provide your family needs, provide everything, even for the ministry. You know, many people these days, they were worrying because they think like the church is also closed, the people are not coming in the church, and they also worry from where they will pay the church bills, the church rents, and all those things from for the workers and for all those things. And I want to tell you, my friends, God's hand is enough to provide all your needs. God's hand is able to save your life, bless your life, because God's hand is powerful. So this morning, I'm encouraging each one of you. You don't have to afraid from where it will come. You don't have to afraid how I will survive. You don't have to afraid how I will pay my bills. You don't have to afraid how I will take care of my staff. Because God's hand is there. God's hand. God's hand. God's hand. Amen. Many people might thinking, sitting and thinking, oh, you don't have to worry. You have lots of things. No, my friends. If you get the revelation, that hand of God is upon you. The Bible, the book of Isaiah 41:10. I get that revelation. It clearly says, fear not, I am with you. Don't look here and there. I am your God. I will strengthen you. And the Bible says, I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. So that's the powerful. His promises are yes and amen. The hand which is above you and me is the Alpha and Omega. The hand which is above you and me is the beginning and the end. The hand which is above you is your and my God. He is the creator of this world. The hand which is above you is not the normal hand, it's the powerful hand of God. So get that revelation. Once you will get that revelation, I'm telling you, you will lack nothing. So don't worry. God is always there. His hand is always there. Waha hat sab samay tapai ra mero mathi cha. And what happened? When you will read the Matthew 14, the verse 31, the Bible says Jesus immediately. I like that word. It says immediately. Moment you will cry out to God, immediately. He says, Lord, help me. Immediately he stretches his hand and hold him. If you are also thinking you're losing the things, it's almost going. Cry out. He will hold. He will hold. He will give his righteous right hand. He will hold you. He will hold your business. He will hold your job. He will hold your family. He will hold everything for you because he is able. And when Jesus stretched his hand, even the water could not king him. Dubaunu sake na. Usko duba nahi paya jab Parmeshwar ne apna hath ko diya. Even pani bhi usko duba nahi paya. Pani le pani, te khola le pani. Ula dubaunu sake na. Because that's the powerful. And what happened? What the Bible says? When he gave his hand, when Jesus gave his hand, he took him back and took Peter in the same boat where he was. In another word, that comfort zone. Jab Parmeshwar le tapailai hat dinu huncha, wahale tapailai tyo dubnu dekhin bachayera tapailai tyahi thau ma pugauncha, tyo nau ma pugauncha jun chahi euta aram ko jaga thiyo. So don't worry. Don't worry. Don't worry. God's hand is for you and for me. He will take you back to the same place where you were. Wale Patras lai tyo thau ma pugaunu bhayo. He took Peter in the same place, in the same boat. You also, if you're thinking you're losing your job will be okay. If you're thinking your business is getting down, your business will be okay. If you're thinking there is nothing, nobody take care of you, I'm telling you, everything will be okay, because His hand is powerful. He saved. He stretched His hand. While apno hat la badaunu boy, He stretched His hand. He hold the Peter and He took him back to the same place. In this pandemic situation, if you're thinking your job you're losing, I'm telling you, the hand of God is upon you. That hand will take you to the same place which you have. If you're thinking your business is losing, you're not getting any profit, day by day is going down, I'm telling you, if you cry out to God, God will stretch His hand and He will hold you and He will take you to the same place where you were before. He will take you. If you're thinking everything you're losing in this pandemic situation, I'm telling you, fear not. God is with you and He will take you to the same place where you were before. Hallelujah. If you're thinking the church is empty, no people are coming, I'm telling you, the hand of God is upon our ministry, upon our church, upon our people. We will be reached to the same place where we were. Aaj aradhana garnu paeko chaina. Dherai manisharu church, they are not coming in the church because of the situation, because of the government rules. But I'm telling you, the hand of God is upon our ministry. The hand of God is upon our church. Our church will be again fill up. Our house, our buildings will be again fill up, and we will see the people, we will see the crowd, and we will together, we will worship the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. This Sunday when I went to the last Sunday when I went to the church, it's really break my heart also. Before we were like 120, 150 people were coming every Sunday and worshiping the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And this now in these days, only we are allowed to bring only the 20, 25 people, not more than that. And it's really break my heart. It's really break my heart. I pray, and that God told me, don't worry, fear not. Things will be okay. Things will be normal. So I'm waiting for that day, because the hand of God is upon me. God, when Peter was king, he cried out to God. Jesus stretched His hand and He took him back. He held His hand. He bring him out and took him to the same boat where he was before. Same thing is going to be happen with you and me. The churches, the buildings which is empty today, God is going to fill it again. Hallelujah. Just trust God, fear not. The book of Job, you know the story of Job. He lost everything. He lost his children. He lost his wealth. He lost his friends. Everything he lost. But he feared not. He was not afraid. He just honored God. He called the name of Jesus. And what the Bible says, God gave him everything back. Everything. More than before. He gave him back. The same thing is going to be happen. If you're drinking, you're losing your job. If you call the name of Jesus, I'm telling you, better is coming. If you're thinking your business is getting down, if you call the name of the Lord, God will stretch your hand and you will see your business is getting better than before. Everything will be all right. That's why the hand of God is powerful. His hand is above us. His hand is holding our life. Our life is protected under the hand of mighty God. Our life is protected under the hand of mighty God. I'm telling you, my friend, the hand of God is upon us. Hallelujah. We are protected under the hand of mighty God. Don't say nobody is there to help me. Nobody is in the front. Nobody is in the back. You don't have to say that, my friend, because God is for us. His hand is over us. His hand. The Bible says his hand. He says righteous hand. His righteous hand will uphold us. What a promise. What a wonderful promise we have. We don't have to be afraid, my friends. I know things are bad. I know the situations are bad. But nothing is impossible with our Lord Jesus Christ. Things will be all right. You just fear not. You don't have to fear in this pandemic situation, in this situation which is going around the world. You don't have to be afraid, because the hand of God is above you and me. We are protected. We are protected. God is providing. God is taking care of us. You just have faith in God. You just have faith in God, because the hand of God, just have faith that God's hand is able to protect our life. That's all. You don't have to do anything, my friends. I'm telling you, because hand of God is above us. Get that revelation. I'm happy because God gave me that revelation. I'm not afraid. I'm not afraid with the sickness and disease. I'm not afraid with the lacking. I'm not afraid with any things, because I know my God is able to protect my life. I know my God's hand is above me. I know my God's hand is protect everything. Peter, when he was going down, when he was skiing the water, he stressed immediately. Bible says immediately Jesus is ready. His hand, he will never leave us, not forsake us. He is with us 24 hours a day. You can say that 24/7. Whole week, whole month, or you can say whole year, he's with us. So don't be afraid. I'm telling you, my friends, that God is there. उहाँले हामीलाई कहिले पनि छोड्नु हुँदैन, कहिले पनि त्याग्नु हुँदैन. His words are powerful. His words are yes and amen. So everybody have to understand the hand which is above us is powerful. And it's able to protect your life. So I'm not going to speak long, but I just want to encourage all of you. And I think you're blessed. I believe you're blessed. And I just tell each one of you to just remember the hand of God is upon you. So before you start your day, before I leave the life, I just want to pray for you, and I want to pray for each one of you who is watching me the life. Father God, I come to your throne in Jesus' name. I pray for each one of them, O Lord God. Father, help them to understand that your hand is above us. Help us to understand, O Father God, that your hand is able to protect our life, provide our needs, of Father God. Even in this situation, if these people are losing their job, losing their business or the things of Father God, help them to understand that your hand is above them, and that hand is able to give everything back in their life more than before. And Father, I just speak your blessing upon their life, O Father God. Take care of them. Bless them, O Lord God, as many of them are going to start their day, O Father God. Father, bless their day, O Lord God. Many of them, they're going to sleep, taking rest, O Father. I pray that you will give them the sound sleep, O Lord. Bless them, O Father God, so they can glorify your name, O Father. I speak your blessing upon each one of them, and I speak a blessing, O Lord God. Father, take care of them, bless them in the name of Jesus. Amen, amen, amen. If anybody has any kind of prayer, if you want to share with us, you can message me in my Facebook or in my Facebook message, or if you have my WhatsApp number, you can just WhatsApp me that your prayer request, and we love to pray for all of you. We love to pray for you guys. Our church, our team is praying every day from 5 o'clock till the 6 o'clock in the evening. We are doing a kind of chain prayer. Everybody is praying one hour, and from 6:30 to 8 o'clock, we just come together and pray, share the word, and we dismiss. So everyone, our team, our church is every day praying from the morning 5 till the 6 o'clock in the evening. So I request, if you have any kind of prayer request, you can send to us. We love to pray for you, and we love to pray with you. And we believe when we cry out, God will give his hand. As Peter cry out, God immediately stretch his hand. Immediately. So God is for you and for me. He's yesterday, today, and forever. He's same God. So you don't have to afraid. Just trust God. Hand of God is upon you. That hand is powerful. I just speak the blessing upon your life. And just believe the hand of God is upon you. Amen, amen, amen. May God bless you and have a blessed day, or you are going to sleep, then blessed night. May God bless all of you. In Jesus' name, amen, amen.